Hello everyone, today we're gonna show you how to deploy the AWS Security Hub Smart Connector. First, to have a better understanding on how the event is being collected, we can see here the AWS have some security services like Mercy, Inspector, and GuardDuty. After these services being enabled, they will create some security findings. After that, the Security Hub will collect those findings from the security services and will store them for at least 90 days. The Security Hub will forward those findings through the Event Bridge in AWS, and it forward in the AWS security finding format as known as ASFF, and then it will forward the ASFF finding to the SQS queue, and in SQS queue it will act the ASFF as the an event from Lambda. From here, the smart connector running in the AWS Lambda will read the event and convert it from the ASFF into ArcSight CEF. This CEF will be sent to the syslog ng daemon listening on port 1999 over TLS protocol, and then it will send it to the final destination. Because this connector is a special connector, the way we install it is not similar with other connectors. For that, in this video, we will show you how to deploy and config the AWS Security Hub Smart Connector. For this guide video, we will separate it into two videos. Part 1 is how to prepare the environment to install the AWS Security Hub Smart Connector. Part 2 will focus on install and configuring Smart Connector. In this video, we will have this main topic. One is create AIM user group, set the AIM permission, create VPC, create security group, add rule, create EC2 instance, and create S3 bucket. Starting from here, we will create the IAM group and user. Go to the IAM services. Click on user group. We have already create group ArcSight with the required permission. You guys can refer to the permission on the screen and add it exactly the same as the permission we have created here. Because we have already created one group, so that we won't create a new one. But please allow me to guide you how to create the new user group and add permission to it. First, click on the create group. After that, give it a name you like. Scroll down here. Here's for the permission. You can search the permission, and please notice to search the permission that have exactly like ours here, like Amazon EC2 full access, Amazon S3 full access. Like I'm searching here, there is Amazon EC2 full access, then add it. In this case, if you're deploying, you can pause the video and add it exactly like the screen. For the user, All you have to do is add a user, tick on I want to create AIM user, give it a custom password. Click Next, and then choose the permission group that you have just created earlier. Because we already create one user, so that I will cancel this. That is how you create the new user and group. For the next step, click on the user you created. You will see the user ID. This ID will be needed to log in to that user. I will try to log in to that user. From here, choose the IAM user, paste the user ID of the user you have just copied, use the username and password you have just created, and then sign in. For the next step here, we will create the VPC. Go to VPC service. Click on create a VPC. Choose the VPC and more. Click on create VPC and then click on view VPC. After that, scroll down and then choose the security group. Okay, after that, you choose the create new security group. And then name it. Then give it the description and then choose the VPC that you have created earlier in VPC info. In the inbound rule, we will add some rule. The first one will be the custom TCP. For the SWAT info, choose anywhere IPv4. And then add the same custom TCP. For this one, we will choose the IPv6. After that, add the new rule for SSH for both IP version 4 and IP version 6. And the last one will be RDP for both IP version 4 and IP version 6 as well. After that, on the custom TCP rule, I will set the port range to 1999 for both IPv4 and IPv6. Then save it. The next step here, I will create the EC2 instance. Here, I will create the public instance and name it public one. And then browse the AMI. Choose the community AMIs. And then I will choose Amazon Linux. I will choose the 64-bit. Then we will choose the first one. For the key pair name, you can create a new key pair. And then enter the name you want and click create key pair. In this case, as we already have our key pair, so that we won't create a new one, we use the existing one. Next is edit the network setting. This one is the public, so that I will choose the public subnet. Here's public one. Then enable the auto assign IP. Select the existing security group and then choose the one that we have created before and then launch the instance. We will refresh it and you can see the public one have been created. We will create the same with the private one. Only for the subnet, we will need to choose the private subnet. For the key pair here, please note it that the key pair must use the same one that you create for the public one. And the subnet here, we will use the private one. Next is to create the S3 packet. Choose create packet. Then choose the AWS region and give it a name. And then create packet. And for the packet you have just created, you will upload the connector installation file as well as the configuration file onto that packet. Okay, you can see these two instances has been successfully deployed. And okay, that is all the step that need to be done to prepare the installation. We will have the part 2 video of this guiding installation and configuration for this connector. Thank you very much for the time watching. Thank you.